Hey, what's up? John Sonmez from simpleprogrammer.com. So I got a question. This is another health and fitness related video, but this one is on coffee drinking. It's a little bit off topic at first, but I think it's worth reading you here. So this question is from Jay, and he says, I've been following your content for about 10 months. Now, I believe after you released the Simple Programmer podcast, I think a lot of your ideologies are great, and there is rarely anything you say that I disagree with in general. I would really like to start following your advice on getting girls and becoming confident in general. However, I find that when I focus too much on chasing girls, since to get anywhere with them often requires a lot of attention, I fall behind on my career goals and waste a lot of time. All right, good. Yeah, don't do that then. How would you recommend dealing with social life and meanwhile studying software development? To add to the context, I'm 23. I work full-time, go to school part-time some semesters and full-time some semesters, and I have two kids. And I ended up asking a question completely unrelated to what I actually want to ask. Scratch that, but this might be an interesting topic for you. Okay, I'll actually address some of that too. But so my original question was going to be, what is your take on coffee consumption or caffeine in general? Good, bad, somewhere in the middle. I don't consider myself a heavy coffee drinker since I can go days without it, unlike most people I know. However, I do find it hard to study, work on side projects, or do homework after a long day and need to grab a cup of coffee so I can get things done. I don't want to become dependent on coffee to be able to be productive, but it's the only thing that works most of the time. Sometimes I can get away with a cup of tea, but still, caffeine. Regards, Jay. So Jay, you're a little scatterbrained there. Maybe you drank too much coffee before you wrote that email. Let's see, where to address? So let me see, the first thing that you talked about was how to deal with social life while maintaining studying and software development. That's tough. You know, I think, get some bells ringing, Santa Claus. It must be Christmas here. Doesn't it feel like Christmas? It looks, where's the snow? All right. We'll just listen to those bells for a little bit. It's a long series of bells. That's why Santa Claus is coming down. Well, that's enough of that. I think I'm just gonna plow on through. Forget the bells. So anyway, here's the thing. Anything that you're trying to undertake, any serious undertaking that you're gonna try to undertake, is gonna require sacrifice, right? So if you're seriously, like, if your schedule is loaded and you're really devoted to enhancing your career as much as possible, I'm not gonna lie, your social life is going to suffer. It is just going to, especially with everything you've got on your plate. Something has to give. You're gonna have to make sacrifices somewhere. The first place I always ask people to make a sacrifice is watching TV. Because that's just stupid. Why are you watching TV? That's a waste of your time. If you feel like you don't have enough time and you're spending any amount of hours watching TV, just unplug it, throw it in the trash can, and never turn it on again, because that's just a total waste of time. So that's where I would start. If you still don't have enough time, and I've done this, I did this blog post on how you're wasting your time. Check out that blog post and you can go through that. And if you still don't have enough time, then it means that you just have to make a sacrifice. So you might just have to sacrifice your social life for some period of time in order to get ahead. And then, you know, I like to live my life in phases where I'm focused on one thing very much for a phase. And then at a different point in my life, there's more bells, it's different bells. This is weird. Anyway, at a different point in my life, I focus on something else. So maybe what you're gonna do is you're gonna devote some amount of time to focusing on your career and building up your skills and getting your job or, you know, whatever. And then once you've got that going, then maybe you focus some period of time in your life on increasing your fitness goals, right? And getting in shape or something like that, right? And then maybe after that, then you work on improving your social life and your skills and your social circle. The bells are ringing and kids are yelling. This is crazy. Okay. Anyway, you see what I'm saying? Like, you might want to shift between those things. Okay. Now let's talk about the caffeine. So I need some caffeine. Dang it. Anyway, I don't really care that much about caffeine. Like, first of all, I don't like anything to be a crutch, right? I'll probably do a video on alcohol and smoking and why I don't like those things, especially alcohol, mainly because I don't like anything that's a crutch. Right? I don't want to utilize something that is going to help me get through that I won't be able to do on my own. I'd rather build up my own personal strength and develop myself rather than relying on a crutch. So if you're using caffeine as a crutch, then you shouldn't use it. Now, with that said, I took a caffeine pill this morning. I didn't actually drink coffee because I'm, with my diet program, I'm taking caffeine and ephedrine because it's a proven stack. I know some people think ephedrine's dangerous. Fine, whatever. You can argue with me and tell me I'm killing myself or whatever, but it's been effective for bodybuilders for 20 years. So I take caffeine and ephedrine a few times a day. And you know, if I don't have caffeine, if I have to taper off of it, I definitely feel it, right? I don't feel like it really affects my productivity that much, though. If it does for you, then okay, you know, there's not really much harm in it. I don't think there's much harm in drinking coffee. Just realize that, you know, you're going to be handicapping yourself. If you're relying on the caffeine in order to get stuff done and you can't work without caffeine, you're going to be handicapping yourself and using that as a crutch instead of developing your focus and concentration on your own, which will be more valuable. So I would try to develop the focus and concentration, and then if the caffeine enhances it, if it makes it better, you know, drinking some coffee, then that's great, that's fine. You know, but if you're using it as a crutch, then it's bad. But overall, you know, there's lots of studies on caffeine and whether it's good or bad. I think for the most part, a little bit of caffeine shows to be beneficial, especially coffee. We won't know, you know, for sure, but it definitely doesn't seem to be extremely harmful. So, you know, balance, weigh it out and see what you think. I think you could go either way on it. There's a couple of good books on it. You could search on Amazon. This is amazing with the bells, I gotta tell you. you can search on Amazon and find, you know, books on caffeine. I think there's one called Caffeine Blues or something like that. And people, you know, there's people that are so against it and people that are so for it. I say use it in moderation and don't become addicted to it and don't rely on it and don't use it as a crutch. That's it. And if you wanna drink coffee, it's not a huge deal, right? I drink coffee from time to time. You know, I've gone for periods without any coffee to test it, to see if it helps my mood, my state, and everything. And I've found that I'm in a better mental state in general when I'm using some amount of caffeine or drinking coffee. So, you know, test on yourself. See what you think and see what you come up with. That's the best thing I could say. So, anyway, hopefully you enjoyed this video and the surprise visit from Santa Claus. And if you want to, you know, get more videos with bells in them, this is the place for bells, apparently. So just go ahead and click that subscribe button and you'll get more videos with bells and ducks, screaming kids, all that kind of fun stuff here in San Diego. and I'd appreciate it. So if you like this video, click the subscribe button or the like button, and I'll talk to you next time. Take care.